Good morning everybody and welcome to this game between iG.Vitality and Newbee.Young for the Nanyang Championships Season 2. We're gonna be taking a look at this game today. I haven't casted in a little while, mostly because of my voice, right? I had some issues there, but I'm feeling a lot better now, so I thought let's get back into it, you know. It's something I always enjoy, it's really something I do for myself, but hey, you know, maybe some of you actually enjoy this as well, but anyhow. We're doing this game specifically because I couldn't download the replays for any other games. This is the only one that worked, so I really didn't have much of a choice. But let's get into it, let's go and talk about the draft a little bit. So, as per picks, we've got a draw range on the Batch Rider for iG.Vitality. They are both, of course, ranged heroes because, you know, got a draw ranger. Usually you see a team consisting of only ranged heroes. If there's a draw ranger in the team, maybe one support that's going to be melee, something like that. But you can already see the Oracle and the OD coming out from iG.Vitality as well. Oracle, I think, is actually really interesting. There's a little bit of hidden synergy between Oracle and draw ranger because Oracle got a lower base attack time than any other support or even any other ranged hero in the game. So because of that, Oracle can actually get a lot more value out of the draw ranger aura because he will be attacking more often, you know, so his DPS is higher compared to other supports. Kind of interesting, the Earth Spirit coming out last from iG.Vitality. Now it's actually going a lot quicker than it is common. Okay, well, we didn't even get a chance to talk about the bans, but whatever. Lion, Tidehunter, Invoker, Phoenix, and Juggernaut for Newbee.Young. This seems to be just a really solid draft. Nothing too aggressive. Probably a little bit more defensive, trying to play for victory at like 30 to 40 minutes. That's where they're going to start, right? But before that, they're probably going to be chilling a lot, you know, make sure that the Invoker and the Juggernaut are powerful. Which, of course, is quite reasonable. Anyway, Earth Spirit already heading into the bottom lane. Dogfight's playing the support here. Gonna be putting down his sentries. As you can see, this one blocking this camp right here. And then, of course, you've got the Observer Ward, making sure this area is blocked off. You know, kind of making life easier for in July on the Batchrider, because he's really gonna need it. Batchrider is a hero that struggles a little bit, right? He can definitely offlane pretty damn well, there's no denying that, but sometimes it can get a little bit tricky if you're going up against the wrong heroes. So, in July, just hiding in the forest here, you know. Probably gonna be leeching some experience, so we'll see what he's got in mind down here. But just chilling, playing it safe, no need to go for the bounty, no need to risk your life. Other players, we got Sakata playing the OD going into the mid lane. I assume seems like it, yeah, based on the item build. Then we've got Paparazzi on the draw ranger in the top lane. And last, of course, we got Oracle being played by Super, who is just kind of chilling here. I imagine those two, the draw ranger and the Oracle, they're just going to be at the top lane. They're just going to be chilling and mostly be left alone. Honestly, it's a hard lane to go up against, right? And it's going to be tough to really get some damage done there. On the other side, we've got Lin on the Juggernaut. At the bottom lane, just kind of chilling. Wrong on the Lion. Of course, we've got 290 playing the Invoker. It's a funny name, but okay. Lee on the Phoenix. And last on the Radiant is going to be Thule on the Tidehunter. Batchrider. Oh, actually pulling some funny shit. Look at this. He's pulling the creep wave. Now, my question is, where is he pulling the creep wave to? Firefly is about to run out. And in the meantime, we actually have a fight in the mid lane. OD manages to snatch the first spot on the Invoker. I'm sorry, there's too much happening at once already. Yeah, but, you know, it's a replay. That's fine. Okay, we got the Invoker. He got trapped up. He's just going to be beaten up by the Earth Spirit. So, frankly, I think we made the right call. This down here is a lot more interesting. So where's in July going with this? He's got the creep wave. He's just going to be pulling it back into the lane, it seems. Yeah, so this is a pretty common strategy. This is just meant to make it so your creeps are fighting closer to the tower, right? Like you can see this creep wave is not going to be fighting over here. And that allows in July to actually get some golden experience, which would usually be a struggle. That in return, you know, allows him to get him to level 2. And then once the Batrat is level 2, the hero just becomes so much more powerful, right? Like, having the Sticky Napalm as well as the Firefly is a huge deal. Just one of them really, really doesn't cut it, but both insanely powerful. So, we can see again, Batrider now level 2. Monk Creep Wave is plenty for that. Actually gonna be going up against the Phoenix and the Lion now. Yeah, this is what I meant with, like, Batrider can struggle a little bit. Yeah, you can see right there, in July, he's trying his best, but honestly, it's gonna be a little difficult here. Anyway, in the mid lane, we got another dive on the Invoker, but Invoker is gonna end up being fine this time around. Top lane, of course, you just got the Titans are going up against the Draw Ranger. Like, this is, again, probably gonna be a very calm lane, right? Like, unless we have some interference from outside of this little microcosm, there's nothing that's really gonna happen here. Titans can definitely play safe enough to not have to worry about dying, and, well, as long as he really, you know, makes sure he's got plenty of HP and such, but Titan is pretty damn tanky, right? This hero can definitely take some hits. And at the same time, Draw Ranger doesn't need to worry about anything from the Titan, of course. But actually, we got Interference. Two lane are taking a lot of damage. Dogfights, actually dogfighting it up. Oh no, that's not going to be enough. And now the heals. Oracle trying to nuke down two lane right there, but it's not going to be enough. And if you don't get that, then frankly, the Titan is just going to be fine from there. Now we're going to pick up his Iron Talon as he heads back to the base. Mid lane, it's just going to be Sakata going up against 290. These two, it's actually an interesting matchup, I think, right? And I also think it's interesting that the OD is actually going for the Astral Imprisonment. You know, there you go, going to throw that out. And it's going to be a nice, easy setup for Dogfight. They get the stun, but the Phoenix Laser. Oh, the Phoenix Laser. Couple that with the Cold Snap, but OD is going to be fine. He's fast, he's tanky, he can take some hits. Now, not only does he have high natural movement speed, but already picking up boots, not going for a bottle, not going for anything else, just making sure. Actually, what am I saying? He's got a bottle. Sorry. He's just really farmed. Okay. It's unusual for somebody to have both the bottle and the boots at this stage already, but I guess they killed the Invoker twice now, right? Dogfights are taking a lot of damage. He should go down, and Sakata trying to maybe turn it around a little bit. He's got the trap. There's going to be 150 damage on the line there. Not enough, not quite yet, and the Hex coming out, turning him into a little fish who's just gonna have to bounce away. Maybe he's just gonna have to go retreat and go find himself a rune. Finding rune. Get it? Because Finding Nemo. No, I'm sorry. But yeah, I actually got tripped out a little bit by the OD being this far, but OD is doing great. Look at this guy, man. He is really, really farmed, especially compared to the Invoker. And that is scary, right? Juggernaut, of course, being the most farmed in the game. That's just hitting creeps. 23 denies as well. Just making sure that whoever is down here is not getting any farm. And if nobody's down here, then I just really hate creeps. Right? That's just where the Juggernaut is at. He just really does not like the creeps and he just wants to get rid of them. From both sides, really. So that's what he's doing, just kind of farming up a little bit. Actually, a Batrider going in. He's got 4 stacks of Sticky Napalm, but a spin. Yeah, that is the problem, right? The Batrider really doesn't have a good way of dealing with the Juggernaut. The spin simply makes it so he will never be able to kill him unless he somehow baits it out first. But frankly, that it seems unlikely, especially as time passes. You know, the spin gets lower and lower in cooldown. Once Juggernaut is at level 7, frankly, that's just not going to happen. However, Lin? Oh, the spin is on cooldown right now. Still, Juggernaut is going to end up being fine. Nonetheless, I'm sure that this is going to at least have a little bit of a negative impact on him. You know, the annoyance of having people there is always a big deal. Super is caught in a bit of an awkward spot here, actually. Seems he's just going to be abandoned by his team. Yeah, putting down a ward very aggressively. Going down for it, and now the Void is going to be denied. Probably not worth it. Oh well, Draw Ranger just chilling up at the top. Pushing down the tower, you know, getting some damage in there. That's usually what you want to do, right? This is really the the thing in this game. On the one side, we got the Drow Strat. On the other side, we got just you know, some casual heroes thrown together. Juggernaut being very powerful. Oftentimes, it seems to me like one team picks a strat, right, and the other team just kind of picks to deal with that, right? So it seems like in this game, you just have a Drow Strat. It's not a very heavy Drow Strat, right? A little bit of one. And then on the other side, you just got, okay, so they got Batrider, so we can pick the Juggernaut. Juggernaut's going to do fine against Batrider, and as you can see, against the Earth Spirit. So those heroes can't really do anything against us there. And actually, he's going to do well against everybody. Wow. Juggernaut is a really nice pick here. I actually really like that hero here. I mean, the worst matchup he's really got is, I guess, the OD or something. Oh, no. In July, trying to steal those creeps. That's actually a big deal. I mean, if he gets those, he's actually gonna get most of them. One of them goes to the Lion there, but a little bit unfortunate that the Juggernaut didn't manage to snatch those. This is actually one of the advantages of being this aggressive right now, isn't it? Yeah, this aggression simply makes it so the Juggernaut doesn't really have time to farm the jungle or something like that, right? And he can definitely take stuff like that down. Usually you want the healing ward up, like, up for it. Right, and I guess level 7 is pretty handy, but you just kind of spin on it. You pull it. What I like to do, okay? I don't know if this is what everybody does. And I don't know if this is the right way, right? But this is how I like to go about it. As I pull the creep wave in, put down a healing thing, and I spin on it, right? And I just sacrifice my creeper if they can't just tank it for me, right? That tends to work pretty well. But again, the Batrider being here, the Earth Spirit being here really shuts that down. And also, we got the Drow Ranger now coming in. A smoke, sneaky smoke. Two heroes hidden. They only see in July. How are our wards looking? So, the Dire does know. Actually, wait, no, the Radiant. The Radiant does know where the Dire is, but the Dire is now coming in. It's still smoked up. They're still smoked up. OD? Oh, I think Newbee might think they might be in a good spot here, but no. Wrong. He gets one hit. Two hits. He's actually still okay though. In July, one star bomb, but that's gonna be a dead lion. Now we got the Phoenix going down. I did not expect that. The Phoenix actually died before the lion did. All right, a smoke attempt definitely worked out right there, and seems like iG Vitality is gonna be quite happy about this. It's actually kind of an interesting name for, like, the secondary team, isn't it? Vitality. Cherry? That's funny, my Cherry. That's probably one of their sponsors, right? Like, Cherry. I imagine, so it just looks a little bit funny. Oh, by the way, at the bottom, Paparazzi going down, the Sunstrike. Not even going to be necessary in July. Now on the run, the Phoenix Laser dealing a lot of damage. The Batrider will most certainly be chopped up, sliced into the little slices of bad sushi eaten up by the Juggernaut, and seems actually gonna have a push now. Yeah, got four heroes at the bottom. Four heroes at the bottom. I mean, this seems like about as good as of a time as you're gonna get to, you know, get a little bit of damage done here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and work on this tower a little bit. A TP in from the Drow Ranger again. Actually, look at this lady. We're looking to fight. Looking to fight. Definitely. This top lane took down the tower and is now just kind of abandoning, trying to use that easy farm she had to shut down the Juggernaut, who had a little bit of a harder time. And you can see her farm, her last hits are actually ahead of everybody else. She is the most last hit heavy hero in the game. Now, of course, her farm isn't the best simply because she died once. Right, but on the other hand, you have that OD who is like super fucking buff. Dogfight's gonna be called out right here and it's just gonna be chopped up yet again. Juggernaut also, of course, can be quite aggressive. Now, in July, actually going for 290 right there on the Batrider. Gonna be trapped for Sakata, who in return trying to take down the Invoker, but that's not going to be enough. And actually, he gets turned around on. They lose three. And in July, somehow surmised. Interesting. The one guy I really thought was gonna go down, but no. Batrider manages to get himself out of there. And it seems like Newbee is actually really starting to turn it up right now. I mean, the aggression was coming out from IG, but it just simply hasn't worked out for them. And now Lin is at the bottom. The spin out, the Sunstrike, is it enough? No, not quite. A nice silence right there, securing her getaway, but wow, that's still definitely close. Now, I wonder what the Juggernaut is going for here. One item I would absolutely love to see here is just a casual Blink Dagger, right? Probably not right away. Almost certainly not right away, actually. But a Blink Dagger is definitely going to be very, very useful, right? It's just something that allows you to close the distance with the Draw Ranger, which is huge. That is the one issue you're gonna face this game, right? Probably actually a BKB is not a terrible idea, but you know, you always got the spins on us. I don't know, as a Juggernaut, do you really want to buy a BKB? No, of course not, but sometimes you just kind of have to. But anyhow, have a little bit of a push here in the mid. OD picking up a 4-star, so that's what he spent his money on. Probably gonna see that build into a Hurricane Pike, but just gonna push himself out of there. I mean, a 4-star is really just a fantastic item for that hero, right? Like, super, super sick, honestly. And just like being able to build into the Hurricane Pike as well, right? I love Hurricane Pike on OD. And mid push from Newbee there. Oh, they're definitely trying to be aggressive here. Oracle caught out, and oh god, he's taking so much damage. Even using the Juggernaut ultimate, Omni Slash, gonna destroy the Oracle, and mid tower goes down. In the meantime, we got Paparazzi pushing the bottom, gets that tower, and is now trying to apply some pressure on the tier 2 here. So at least a little bit of a return. Also working on his 4-star, so just getting that right away. And it seems they really want to prioritize having that mobility, right? And again, trying to get away from the Juggernaut, who is picking up the Yasha, which is expected, right? Probably gonna get... I'm actually not sure if that's gonna be a Sengen Yasha or a Manta Star. Could be both, honestly, but I like the Yasha in general, right? That's fantastic, especially with the face boots and also just the casual Windlace. He's fast, right? He needs that. He needs the mobility. Oh, the lion. He's kind of caught out. Do they have any detection, though? No. Oh, no. Don't walk in back into that. Okay. There's a sentry right there. Oh, okay. He's back into it now. Roshan being attempted. Finger on super. Super gonna go down, but wrong. He's definitely going to pay the ultimate price and fall as well. So, it's a one for one. That might actually have worked out for the Radiant, though. Not sure. A little bit of a silly encounter right there. At least Roshan wasn't taken down, so Newbee got that going for them. No, that's actually a good point, though. I mean, they did manage to stop Roshan with that. And now we got to fight at the bottom, and look at this Newbee there coming in. The Phoenix dive, it misses mostly, but in July he's taking a lot of damage. He grabs the spinning Juggernaut. That's just really not that powerful, though. Phoenix Egg in the background. Cicada manages to get that all on his own. And Juggernaut is somewhere. Actually, where the hell did the Juggernaut go? He's running. Titans are going down as well. And now, IG, they're chasing Newbee. Lin gonna be forced to spin. He is very fast, though. I mean, our Juggernaut is speedy as all hell, so he should be fine. In the end, that's a 2-for-nothing. 2-for-nothing, but IG is showing they can definitely fight this. It was interesting, though. It's so split up that the OD managed to just get the Phoenix kill all on his own. That is very unusual. And Roshan, this time around, I don't know if there's anything Newbee can do. They are out of position, and Titan is still dead. At the same time, it's not the quickest Roshan, so if they really hurry, they might be able to intercept, but it doesn't seem like that's even... No, that's not even something they'll attempt. They're gonna blast a Sunstrike in there, get a little bit of damage done, but that's gonna be the end of that. And Roshan Force, likely going to the Draw Ranger. Yep, there we go. Who's now working on... Dragonlance? Dragonlance. I mean, Hurricane Pike, I assume, right? Just straight Hurricane Pike. Nothing wrong with that on a Draw Ranger. Like, it's just really solid, so... I mean, it used to be the case that people bought a Blink Dagger on Draw Ranger, right? Just because you really needed some sort of positioning tool. And the Hurricane Pike is like, oh my god, amazing stats, amazing utility, and a positioning tool? Okay. This is a dream. Meantime, Phoenix in the mid, gonna be burned down from the Oracle. It's kind of interesting that the Purifying Flames actually hurt the Phoenix. I mean, you would imagine that a Phoenix has flames about as pure as they come, but suppose not. A Titaner gonna be able to finally get himself some money, you know, taking down that big stack of Ancients. I'm sure he's praying that he doesn't get intercepted here. That would be a little bit unfortunate. They're pinging it out. Somebody is. It seems that Lin was actually that one. Yeah, Lin is pinging it out. They're pinging out the OD, actually. Hexing him up. The Omni Slash used immediately. Stunned and Sunstruck even. Even coming too late, though, because OD is already dead. That was interesting. OD chilling there forever. Just kind of asking for it, honestly. But that's going to be a mecha on the Tidehunter. And wonder what he's going for next. I mean, mecha is obviously a little bit tricky just because, you know, mana is an issue. You can see right now Ted on this kind of running low, and he's got mana boots. That should keep. That should be okay, right? That should be fine. But the question is just, does he go for the Guardian Grace now, or is he gonna head for the Blink Dagger? Maybe 4-star, right? Like, that's generally the line of purchases that you would expect. Oh, Paparazzi. Ooh, that was close, man. That was definitely close. I managed to get himself out of there, and he almost got his Hurricane Pike. Hurricane Pike, the recipe is super cheap, so he's just gonna go ahead and buy that really quick. There we go. Like, the thing is, if you got a Force Staff and a Dragon Lance, there's really no reason to not get a Hurricane Pike. And oh god, Paparazzi, you're not getting out of this one. He's gonna need some backup. He got the Resurrection. They're gonna buy him 3 seconds. And he's back. Ravage. Oh, nice silence. Stun as well. The Phoenix Egg gonna be used, but actually that Phoenix Egg is just gonna be popped immediately. Ravage on 3-4 actually. Dogfights. We're gonna see the Oracle Ultimate on him. He's just kind of still okay, actually. Running back into the fight though. No fear. And that long range stun, Lin! Just barely caught out, but he goes down, and Sakala is just dealing too much damage now. The OD completely overwhelming. He's got a Blink Dagger on top of his Voice Staff. The Hurricane Pike almost done. But yeah, that was... that long-range stun from the Earth Spirit, just barely at the very tip catching the Juggernaut. And Newbee, they actually got a bit of a problem now, don't they? I mean, that bottom tower is definitely falling, and they're just not doing well in these fights. Like, that's just the issue, right? Like, they are not winning the fights, and that sucks, right? Like, you really want to be able to actually engage in a fight, because else you'll just end up in a situation where all IG has to do is continue fighting, right? They just need to continue forcing fights, and then you just lose. Because you can't fight properly. So they gotta find some sort of way of dealing with that, right? And I'm sure they're working on it, right? Invoker, you can see, has a lot of money saved up, and that is a big deal. Because all of this money is going to go into that Aghanim soon enough, and that's gonna be a huge buff. Right, that is significant. And we haven't actually seen that much of the Invoker yet. Now, from the most recent fights, like, you might think that there is no Invoker, it's just a Sunstrike that occasionally comes out and crashes on people, but in the end, you know, that's all he does. Now, you can see right here, iG.Vitality, they do have a lead. It is not super significant. It definitely matters, but it's not going to be enough to be like, oh my god, game is over, right? And the game is most certainly not over. However, Newbee.Young, they're going to have to step up something, right? They're going to need to change something up. But that's actually an important thing to note here is we got the Manta style done now on the Juggernaut, right? Invoker almost has his Aghanims. Blink Dagger on the Lion, right? These are all things these heroes didn't have in the previous fights, right? And that all matters. Phoenix, by the way, just working on his Hand of Midas. I mean, he'll get there eventually. It's going to be a pretty late one. Seems he is setting up for a long game, right? Like, that's what that Hand of Midas is. It's just all about, hey, look, we expect this to take a little while. Managed to catch the Oracle right there, though. On the other side, I got the Hurricane Pike here, got the Hurricane Pike and a Blink Dagger over there. Oh, actually, Lee gonna be caught out. It seems they don't even want to use the ultimate from the Batrider. Not even going to be necessary, and down goes the Phoenix, just bullied a little bit. But Batrider also almost has his Force Staff. That's of course the big thing, that's the most important thing on the Battle Rider, the blank 4-star combo. Also picking up drums, so in July, looking quite healthy. Earth Spirit, of course, just slowly working on his blink dagger, I assume. The Oracle got an Ephalance, that's huge. Those cast rangers, they're just insane, right? Like, this hero can be helpful from really, like, for all of your heroes from anywhere in the fight. It's a little bit crazy. But all around, actually, Paparazzi also picking up the Yasha. So, probably gonna be a Mantis all day, I assume. Alright, seems the most reasonable. And the BKB coming out on Sakata soon. Seems the game has slowed down a little bit, and I'm not too surprised by that, right? On the one hand, you can see that IG, they're still applying pressure, right? Like, the Drow Ranger is sitting right here. And there's really no backup. This just shows how confident in their position IG is right now. Right, the Drow Ranger being so far into enemy territory and frankly just showing no respect, that is huge, right? Like, that just shows, okay, yeah, we're not afraid. We are very comfortable with how the game is going. Actually, Lee is just going to be caught out. Oh, the poor Phoenix, man. That's just sad. In the meantime, in the minute, we got Super going to be sunstriked up yet again. And Juggernaut uses his ultimate for dogfights, however, just spins out. But the return spin from Lin. And now Sakata taking a lot of damage. Tornado, not on high enough of a level to connect. But in July, going to be picked up nonetheless. Thule kind of just running about a little bit. But that's 3-4-1 in a very split up all around the map kind of manner. But hey, we're not complaining about that. OD getting really close to the BKB though, and that is an important item, right? OD deals a lot of damage. Just naturally, you don't really need any items that deal more damage, right? It's just not really that important. You just need stuff that allows you to actually click on things. So BKB, Hurricane Pike, Blink Dagger, like that all goes along those lines, right? And then maybe some attack speed. Some attack speed also goes a long way, honestly. Oh, the Phoenix yet again. Man, I really feel for that guy. He's just like, dude, I just bumped my my items here, man. I just want my Hand of Midas, and I don't want to get some farms. A farm, and he always beat me up. See, like, now he has to go back again. Oh, that's just depressing. Actually, a Sentient Yasha on the Drow Ranger. Well, that's a little bit surprising. Usually, you see the Manta Star because it's very good. Very good. But this, I think, is where we're going to see the big push, right? Like, you can see IG, they're definitely grouped up, ready to go. That's the plan, right? The BKB is almost done over here, so just tower a few more creeps. I'm sure they'll be giving the next creep wave to the OD. Oh, maybe not. Maybe they don't care that much. Just gonna take the tower. Alright, that seems reasonable too. I guess there's no reason to overextend. Alright, let's play it safe. Let's just play it safe. Roshan. Just kind of chilling. Yeah. Taking it slow. Blink out from the line over here. But yeah, right now it seems like both teams are just kind of still farming. Right. But look at this. Oh, this is so important. Invoker is slowly getting there. Right? Like, right now, Invoker is not actually... up to this point, Invoker really isn't like, oh my god, he's so insane. Right? But what this Invoker is doing here, what 290 is doing here, is he's actually just going straight 6 slot. Right? He's just like, okay, you know what, I'm gonna get drums, need some stats, right, and then I just want a Hand of Midas because I'm Invoker, and then let me just go ahead and get 6 slotted, right, like, let's just go for the scary items, let's just go big, and that's exactly what's going on, right, he got his Aghanims now, he's got his TP boots, now soon we'll see the Blink Dagger probably, right, and then the Sheepstick, something along those lines, and Invoker is just gonna start being nasty now, right? Because this kind of build makes it so the Invoker doesn't really matter that much for the early stages, right? And he's mostly there to Sunstrike, and again, we haven't seen that much of him during fights. And then, once you have your items, you just get this huge power boost and become so scary, right? So scary. And he is the most farmed hero on his team. Juggernaut, by the way, grabbing the Diffusal Blade. Seems to be a really common build on Juggernaut these days. Just go for the Mantis Stance or the Diffusal Blade. Roshan gonna be going down. BKB picked up on the OD. Of course, the Edge is on the Drow Ranger. Honestly, at this point, it's time to push, right? It is time to just push. Oh, they find the Tidehunter, but not quite quick enough. Oh, actually, no. Phoenix gonna be able to dive out as well on the illusions. Yeah. Scary enough to make it so IG is just ready to settle and, you know, just kind of retreat for the time being. Okay, there we go. That is the upside of doing replays. Also, I can do it whenever I want. This is really the main reason why I do replays. BKB now also in the works on the Drow Ranger. Maybe they want to wait for that too. Oh, actually, Super yet again caught out like that. I'm wrong. Yet again gonna trade his life. In the meantime, over here, got another fight. Lin is taking a lot of damage to return Ravage on Frido. And now Dogfights is gonna be the one in trouble. Lin spins out. He's still okay. Still has a decent amount of life. Gonna put down the healing ward. In the meantime, why? 290 coming. God, that name is so stupid. Invoker coming in from the back. And they take down the Drow Ranger. Resurrecting in a second, and now Paparazzi, he is just kind of done. Oh my god, he gets up on the cliff! Oh, that's not going to be enough, though. In July, trying to maybe save it, but not going to be there. Not going to be there in time. OD gets at least a few attacks in, but that was a messy fight. But that was not good for iG.Vitality. The Drow Ranger just got separated, right? Like, that was just a problem, and then there was no way to back her up because you're in this choke point, right? There's no good way of getting in. Invoker also picking up the Blink Dagger. Now, that's exactly what I mean. And now it's just going refresher, right? Like, just straight into the super scary stuff. And this is weird. It gets scary, right? Like, there's not even a better way of putting it. I mean, this Invoker just hurts. And you could feel its impact in that fight already. Tidehunter, Blink Dagger, 4 staff. Probably the Guardian Grease next. So Newbee, they're looking good. They're looking really good. And it's funny how that's not even on the back of the Juggernaut, right? The Juggernaut was mostly used as this like early game tool of, okay, you know what? They're gonna need to deal with this. And it's gonna be a little bit tricky for them, right? So let's just hope that that's enough to buy us some time. And in the late game, we can simply overwhelm the Drow Ranger, because that's the conventional wisdom, right? Like, that's usually what is held as true. Oh, Paparazzi! Actually gonna be caught already at Omni Slash! Oh, man! That's a dead Drow Ranger. Actually, Tornado? Not quite enough. 4 staff is gonna get OD out, but that's a dead Drow Ranger. That's big, man. That's big. Yeah, the conventional wisdom in regards to a Drow Strat, though, is you try to finish by 30 minutes. Right, like, that's when you win the game, and if at 30 minutes you can't do that, then the Drow Ranger really starts being less and less relevant. She just falls off pretty badly, and yeah, that's a bit of an issue there. Now, this is not as true anymore. It used to be like a almost definite truth, right? But these days, Drow Ranger definitely can actually fight even in a late game, but you kind of gotta build for it, right? You gotta go for that Aghanim's. Because then you can farm and keep up. But if you don't have Aghanim's, Drow Ranger doesn't really have a great farming mechanism. Right? She just kind of has to hit each creep individually, and that sucks a little bit. So also no Mantis Star, so even less farming. Yeah, it's gonna be a little bit of a trouble, and a little bit of an issue, right? And you can see Drow Ranger is already starting to fall off, right? In terms of net worth, Invoker, all of a sudden he's first. Right? KTPing into the bottom here. No, still keeping it safe. And I'm gonna go ahead and take those creeps really quick. I'm actually very surprised he did that. I'm very surprised that he killed that range creep. Okay, I know this sounds like a tiny thing, but to me it's just like, why? Right, because he killed the range creep and then used his Hand of Midas on a Magda creep. There's no circumstance where that is better. So, something about that whatever. Tower. Well, that's just a little bit odd. I guess at this point he doesn't really care that much, but I mean, Invoker really wants level 25, right? Like, that's the thing. That's why you buy Hand of Midas on this hero. Like, with everybody else, you're always looking for, you know, level, I don't know, level 16 or something, then you're good. Like, from level 16 to level 25 for most heroes, it's just not that relevant. With Invoker, it really is. You want every single bit of Hand of Midas experience you can get. Now, maybe, I'm probably just overthinking it. So, Nado coming out there, EMP as well. And no, that's not going to connect on anything, and... Well, in July... a little bit of an odd blink right there. Sunstrike? No, Paparazzi's already really low. They get him out of there, and Omni Slash used! The OD is dead! Maybe not quite the healing, but... he should probably pop here. Yep, down he goes! Oh, the quadruple stun. Dogfights are gonna be chased down by the Juggernaut. And just... cut up really quick. That's two heroes down. Yeah, that was just... Man, they're really struggling with that initiation, right? And Roka is keeping them away, and as soon as they go in, like, you can always bet on the Titan of being ready with the return Ravage, and that's just an issue, right? Oh, in July, he's caught out! He's dead! Oh, no. Oh, no, that's three heroes down. That's gonna be a push down the mid. I'm surprised the Juggernaut didn't go for that. You know, go for the Drow Ranger there. Why not? What's worst case scenario? I mean, you're still 2 versus 5. Oh, there we go with the Ravage. Now we're going for the Drow Paparazzi's. Not quite dead, actually. And they just need a few more hits, though. Oh, no, no Fountain Knife? Okay. Alright, gonna play it safe. Super goes down, though. At least they get that. Ah, they went in pretty deep now, and the OD running in. He's got the BKB, drops the ultimate, gets one, gets two. Oh, the ball from Dogfights. The Earth Spirit is still looking for more. He's got a stun ready. The blink away. Oh, no! He gets caught out! Invoker! Invis? That should keep him. Should keep him safe. I mean, he's really fast with that. So I guess they get two return kills. Mid tower still down, though. That's a little bit of a problem. Right, did the Draw Ranger buy back? No, Oracle did. Oracle bought back. So yeah, this game is definitely now going into the other team's favor, right? Like, Newbee is now starting to ramp it up a little bit and get scary. Juggernaut, got a blink dagger now, right? Like, this is exactly what I meant, right? With the Juggernaut, you can just blink in on the draw range and just be right in her face. She pushes you away, your Manta's still out, right? It's just... Man, that's the problem you're gonna face as a draw ranger, right? Now, of course, you got the Hurricane Pike. The thing about the Hurricane Pike, from my experience, like, honestly, the like, whole pushing people away from each other, the active component that you can use on an enemy, right? It's good in theory, but in an actual game, more often than not, that doesn't happen. Right? Like, in theory, a Drow Ranger, as soon as the Juggernaut jumps her, she can just Hurricane Pike him, then they're like 900 units away from each other, and she just shoots him. In theory, but in actuality, that never happens. Ever. Right? So, I don't know. Well, yeah, I guess it happens occasionally, but it's just very rare. A lot rarer than you would guess. So, yeah. Drow Ranger is now walking through the Midian. Picking our helm off a Dominator. So, you know, getting some lifesteal in there. Nothing wrong with that. One thing I like about what iG.Vitality is doing, though, is they're not really slowing down, right? Like, honestly, the past few minutes have not been going well for them, but they don't seem to be showing any signs of fear, right? They're just, okay, you know what? Just stick to the game plan. Keep going, and that is really, really important, right? This is something a lot of teams struggle with. As soon as you start losing, you just kind of get tilted. And once you start getting tilted, well, you start losing even more. So just sticking to the game plan and keeping going. And oh, in July, no, but he's got backup. BKB used as well as the Oracle Ultimate, and Sakade is here. Oh! Gets three of them. Okay, that's two down. That's two down for sure. He's working on the Phoenix. I don't know if he can get him. No, that's not going to be enough on his own. In the meantime, Lin actually going to be picked off. Invoker is still on the run. Silenced. He's got the Lincolns, though. This ability used. And he does the orb. They got detection for days. Who's got it, actually? Oh, Gem on the batch right there. Down goes the Invoker. Only one to survive that one is Phoenix, and yeah, that was definitely a nice response from iG.Vitality there, like seeing what's going on and just immediately intercepting it, showing what they can do. Mocha buying back. He's looking to fight. He's got his Hand of Midas ready too. Should use that. Dude, it pains me to see a Hand of Midas that goes unused. Just use the Hand of Midas, man. Mid-tower goes down, though. Paparazzi, he's just pushing. Yeah, just splitting this up. Just pushing. And... stun misses. The finger connects, though. No. Without the stun, the finger, sadly, just isn't that scary. Oracle, by the way, almost got his Glimmer... actually, he's got his Glimmer Cape now. Just gonna have to drop one of the TPs. I was meant to have this. And another Roshan. Yup. That's gonna be a pretty big kill. And it seems that Newbee either they don't know or they don't think they can do anything about it. They smoked up. But Roshan is still gonna fall. Cheese is on the ground there. Somebody really should get that cheese. Oh, there we go. Yeah, Dogfights gets it. Oh, the Ravage connects on three. Almost four, but OD manages to BKB out of it. Now he's just trying to get a lot of attacks in, you know. Get that damage done, Lin. Omni Slash active. Dogfights go down. The Hex on Sakata. OD gonna be trapped up in the ice wall as well. He's just not really that agile right now. Paparazzi going for 290. Invoker trying to TP out. Oh, that is cheeky, but not going to work. Not at all. And yet again, Newbee losing another fight. I don't think the edges was even used. Was the cheese used? No, not even the cheese was used. That was not good for Newbee. IG taking it back. And now they are ready to knock down that door again. Pushing into the bottom, and Invoker can't buy back this time. I mean, Tidehunter doesn't even have the money for it either, so... Style, maybe the barracks are gonna go down. And problem is, if this barracks goes down, mid-barracks also probably gonna fall. I mean, that tower's already dead, right? Okay. Well. Tower falls. Draw Ranger trying very hard to not get hit by those Phoenix birds, and that's the melee barracks down. They should just move. Ignore the ranged. Ignore the ranged. Who cares about the ranged? Yep, they're going mid. They're gonna get that. That's two lanes of barracks because of one botched fight. Wow. This is a problem now. Oh, actually, I got a stun. Sakata taking a little bit of damage, but the force stuff out immediately. Fish bouncing away. Gonna be just okay. And, oh, the grab! Oh, OD dropping the big ultimate, taking down the Tidehunter after all. Just making sure. No, 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 my friend. You're going down with me. Oh, actually, Sakata. Gonna be caught out here. He's got an Aegis, though, so he will resurrect Paparazzi. Taking a lot of damage too, and IG, they're actually really low. Oh, the instant blink. The instant blink, and now Sakata is looking to fight. I mean, he is pretty damn powerful. He can definitely take on a hero or two. EMP gonna connect. That doesn't do much. Another lion. Just kind of playing hide and seek. In the meantime, Lin chopping up a food here with a triple kill now on the Juggernaut. OD on the run. He's got a sheepstick as well, so he might be able to actually maybe turn. I don't know, he's trying. He's trying very hard. Oh my god, he gets Lin! He gets the juggernaut. Oh, that is very unfortunate for the Radiant here. Wow. Well, my good sir. That sucks. Juggernaut goes. Could he have done anything? Wait, I want to go back. I'm sorry. I'm just very curious if the Juggernaut had a chance at surviving that. Because, no, he didn't. He doesn't have any mana. Oh, man. Actually, the Lion could probably have used his stun earlier, no? Right? Cooldown is ready. He just needs the mana. Can use it now. Didn't. Yep. I blame the Lion. The Lion could have used his stun earlier. If the Lion had used his stun earlier, the Juggernaut would have survived, because that was really close. That was super fucking close. Like, the Lion cast his stun half a second earlier, which he could have. Juggernaut's fine. I'm blaming the Lion. Come on, man. Oh, man. I just really wanted to see what happened there, right? Oh, yeah. Oh, he gets that kill. He is going for a very intelligence-heavy build. This is actually an OD that is very similar to the old OD, right? Like, before he stole intelligence with the Q. Back then, you would probably play an OD like this. So, you know, it's kind of interesting to see that going on. It's still a good build, don't get me wrong there. Just a little unusual, right? And Juggernaut totally needs a BKB. Actually getting a Skadi. I mean, Skadi is good, don't get me wrong, but OD cannot deal with a BKB at all. There's nothing that hero can do. So I feel like that would be a good choice, right? But, you know, what do I know? Octarine Core next up on the invoker here. What did he drop? The drums. Drop the drums. Keeping the Hand of Midas for as long as he can. And actually dogfights. Gonna be caught. Oh my god! The big Ravage here. Oh, they finally managed to get the Earth Spirit. On the run now, though. Tidehunter. I'm trying to get himself out of the ice wall. Gonna be blocking off the Dire. In the meantime, in the background, actually the Lion manages to kill the Oracle yet again. This seems to be a reoccurring theme in this. If I was your English teacher, I would like to ask you, what do you think this means for the Oracle? But frankly, we're not here to do some weird-ass essays. Like, this is really like a reoccurring theme. Like, I gotta be honest here. But, yeah, well. Tidehunter ends up falling though. So it's a 2-for-2. Now, not really the most significant. Like, the thing is, it's just going to delay the game a little bit more. Which, at this point, it's kind of hard to tell in whose favor it's going to go. The problem is, actually, you got to think about it this way, though. Like, IG, they have an OD who's just not going to get more powerful. Right? I mean, what the hell can the OD do at this point? And, oh, God. Oh, no. What was on the courier? That is very unfortunate. Is there any way to check? Huh. Wait, I'm trying to figure out if there's a way to check what's on the courier. Don't I have some buttons for the... Oh no, that's a pause button. Oops. No. No. Okay, well, we would have to go back, but whatever. Well, we all know what it is anyway. It's the butterfly, I assume, right? If I had to guess, I would say it's the butterfly. BKB now on the bat rider as well, by the way. Yeah, and the smoke. The sneaky, sneaky smoke. In July, leading the charge. Looking for something. Hunting. Hunting for the Radiant. Oh, seems they may... Oh, yeah, they definitely have found something there. In July, grabs the Phoenix. Gonna pull him out of his natural habitat and just... see him down really quick. The Phoenix picked off. The smoke is broken. Then it seems the Dire is getting ready for the final push. There's only one lane of barracks left. I mean, they gotta get bottom as well, but 65 life. I mean, that's one attack, right? So, yeah. Tornado EMP actually connecting on two here. Look at that. And Paparazzi, he is, wow, taking far too much damage. The Omni Slash, okay, got a Guardian Grief Seal, but Honestly, the draw ranger should just die. Yeah. Down she goes. Now OD. Oh my god, the triple! The big ultimate Sakata just coming in and cleaning house. However, Tornado still going to connect on him. Another EMP is flying the ice wall. Oh god, OD trying to trap himself. We're looking for the instant blink, but that's not gonna work. Not against the Juggernaut spin and Sakata. He is almost certainly, or well, very much certainly going to fall. Super on the run, Oracle. He's at least gonna go down fighting, right? And IG, they lose everybody right there. Now, buybacks were used. There were definitely some buybacks in there, so I guess it's kind of a 3-4-5, but in the end, this is still very good for Newbee, and they're getting ready to push. I mean, it's only the Lion that's dead, so let's at least get a little bit of damage done, right? We've got the Juggernaut here. It's actually, I wonder what he's going for. There's a gem there. Seems to is. Oh no, he just used buyback. That's why he doesn't have that much money. Right, yeah, no, that makes sense. I'm just like, why doesn't the Juggernaut have anything but just use buyback? Makes sense. Rashan is still down. Infused raindrop on the ground. Casual raindrop. And, well, seems we're pushing. OD. They need him. And I can try to hold without him. So they don't have to use that buyback. But they gotta hold for 30 seconds here. And oh my god, no, they get the Invoker. Invoker gonna be stunned. He's just done. Oh my god. And now the Tidehunter, he's on the run. Trying to get himself out of there. Using the Ghost Scepter. So for the time being, the attacks won't connect. And it seems he's actually gonna be able to do it. Oh no, Phoenix, you canceled it. The egg is gonna be used. And that's a dead Phoenix. Omni Slash in July, he's still okay though, almost certainly dead, but you know, for the time being, we'll mark that as an okay super. Gonna use the invisibility, trying to get himself out of there now. Lin, he's actually caught out and hexed up, and Sakata, the OD yet again, dealing the damage. We got the Invoker buying back, coming back into the fight. Ravage used on the OD alone, and a bunch of creeps. 10 seconds on that ultimate. He's got a lot of intelligence. Oh god, 32 already built up from the steel, but seems not even gonna be necessary. The TP outs from the Invoker and the Lion. And this is not good. This is not good for the Radiant. Newbee, they don't have the Juggernaut. They don't have the Tidehunter. They both bought back last fight. This might just be it. And IG knows it. They're not gonna wait for the Bat Rider. Without the Juggernaut, Newbee just doesn't have the damage. Oh my god! He just pops him. The Lion and the Phoenix get one shot by that ultimate. It's only the Invoker. Actually, the Bat Rider even going as far as to buy back. And dives the Fountain and just kind of drops. Good work, my friend. Good work. It doesn't seem like it's going to matter all that much. The GG is cold after all. And the Ancient is going to explode. And it seems IG is going to take it after a long, hard-fought game. That was a good game. That was a good game. My casting isn't that great yet. Dude, I took a break from this. And this was really something you gotta keep practicing. But anyway, I had a good time. Hope you guys had a good time. If you did, please don't forget to leave a rating on the video, and I'm gonna go ahead and take a look at the endgame stats really quick. So, we got our team experience and net worth. You can see really back and forth, really back and forth. But in the end, IG managing to pull it out. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Don't forget to leave a rating. Goodbye.